guys take a little. Yep. Great.
Yep. Tweet reset. I'm sorry. I lost him. I'm so sorry.
Say reset?
Yep.
Yeah, back to it.
Close the damn door. You're getting dressed for knees.
Now everybody!
Got it. Wait, actually, maybe a little bit my legs hurt.
Don't take no rhythm.
Yeah, yep.
Don't take no style.
Hi, how's everybody doing this evening? Hi, welcome.
It's 3 o'clock in the afternoon.
My name is Sam Centrella.
My name is Giorgio Panetta.
Hi, my name is Ruben Barsky, co-founder of Greaseball Productions, which is now Tookany Creek Films.
We go from the start? All right, cool.
So Peter, he came about from just late night riffing. I don't even know, Peter just showed up one day.
Hi, Peter, how are you?
Hey, Peter. It was always just like this guy, Peter. He was just around in our life. He was like an imaginary friend that we had.
Started as a joke between a couple of friends.
So got me.
Please, come with Peter.
Peter was sort of all of the terrible sort of qualities in a man in one person, and we just called that Peter.
You know, anything from Caddyshack, Rodney Dangerfield, to all the hardcore 70s movies. We started these improvs and it grew into this full world of characters.
This character Peter transformed into, like, what does Peter do for a living?
Worked as in finance, was a janitor. What's really funny, he's a teacher. We're like, oh, that's weird. So Peter's a community college professor. Okay,
what's your profession, Peter?
I don't understand the question.
What do you do for work, asshole?
Teach.
What do you teach?
Economics.
And from there, you know, he had this infatuation with his student, Sabrina Carbonowitz, and he's being chased by this detective, this guy Reno, and then we figured, oh, well, Reno's got to have a partner, and this story started to mesh together. We created this town of Chittenwa.
Chittenwa, USA is like this sort of middle to lower class, seedy.
An East Coast classic 80s town.
Like the parking lot of Roadhouse in 1988.
Like the Simpsons, you know, how they have Springfield. That's what Chittenwa is to Peter.
The backdrop of the town of Chittenwa is that there's, you know, there's a missing persons case that's sort of looming its head over town. And Sabrina and Peter both get mixed up in this.
So we basically decided that we love the story so much that we're gonna create a proof of concept, a short.
Which we shot in a warehouse over a weekend with our production team, our partners, Strange Dream Productions.
We struck lightning and found this really great group of people that we can execute our big budget action comedy feel on a very small scale.
From there, we started to develop this script, this screenplay.
So for months, we kind of incubated and worked on the script all together, going back and forth with ideas, and came up with this idea.
And I would jam pages out and like write scenes and stuff and then show it to Ruben and to Giorgio. And
whatever this is, we gotta go with it because it's gonna be cool as hell.
We can sit there and laugh about it, yell at each other about it, dissect it, rewrite it, and then find something incredible.
So then from there, we decided to have a reading.
Why don't you get your shit together?
Reno flips his coffee table across the room.
Call me if you see anything.
We were only supposed to have, what was it, like
20, 25 people to show.
20 people at the reading.
And we packed this place out.
It was an awesome response.
And from there, we really had this
confidence to move forward to try to make the feature.
Now, where do you come into play? We have about a third of our budget.
Great as that is, we still need your help. We still need you to help contribute and fill these gaps in this film. We gotta pay cast, crew, pay for some locations, cars, everything that's gonna make this movie as aesthetically pleasing as we want it to be for you guys.
There's this feeling right now of, like, what's next? What's gonna come next? Where does the industry go?
We're gonna make sure that people are COVID-free. Temperature checks, everybody on crew has a face mask on, and there's a hand sanitizing station.
It's been a wild year, and the entire entertainment industry basically shutting down.
Friends of mine in the theater are struggling really hard. We owe each other, we gotta lift each other up. And so by giving them what we can, what you can, is gonna be a huge help to making this movie be the best movie it can possibly be.
Thank you so much for watching the video. Really appreciate it. And I hope you enjoy the film and our work. And thank you so much for any contribution you can find.
I really hope you enjoy Peter Galley.
Thank you.
Thank you.